माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टूडे वी विल स्टार्ट चैप्टर 3, एलिमेंट्स कंपाउंड एंड मिक्सचर्स। इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द प्रॉपर्टीज, इट्स क्लासिफिकेशंस एंड कंपोजिशंस। वी नो दैट we have studied about matter, that matter exists in three types. It is classified in three types: solid, liquid and gases. But on the basis of their chemical composition, properties and similarities, their uses, the matters can be classified in three types: elements, compound and mixtures. We have studied that elements and compounds are the pure substances. They are always homogeneous, while mixtures are impure substance. It can be homogeneous, it can be heterogeneous. Now, what is pure substances? The substances which have a definite set of chemical composition, definite set of physical and chemical properties, they all are, means all the pure substances are homogeneous. Their chemical composition is always homogeneous, uniform. Elements and compounds are pure substances. Like gold, iron, they all are, sodium chloride, they all are pure substances. What is impure substance? Impure substances, they are made up of two or more pure substances, but their composition may vary. They do not have a definite composition. Suppose if we mix, iron is a pure substance, copper is a pure substance. We mix iron and copper, add some more copper. Now the composition of copper increases. Add more and more iron. Now composition of proportion of ratio of iron increases. So they are not mixed in a fixed proportion. Such type of combination is called mixture. In a mixture, mixture is a combination of two or more pure substances without any chemical reactions. They may be homogeneous or may be heterogeneous. Since there is no chemical reaction in between the substances, therefore every substances of a mixture, they have their own property. If we mix copper, iron, copper will not be attracted towards magnet, but iron will be attracted towards a magnet. If we prepare a mixture of copper and iron, after putting a magnet, all the iron particles will be attracted towards the magnet, but not even a single copper will be attracted. So all the components of a mixture contains their own property. Now elements are also pure substances. They cannot be changed into any other substance by any physical or chemical process. Suppose if it is iron. Iron can never be changed into aluminium. Aluminium can never be changed into copper. They are made up of only one kinds of atoms. So all the atoms, they are made up of only one kind of atoms. Normally, the elements present on the earth crust, we have 118 elements, out of which 92 are naturally occurring, while the rest 26 are artificially prepared. Many other elements, its research is under consideration. Many researches are going on about some new elements which are found. Now, what are the properties of an element? So, each element have their own characteristics. Each element it is made up of only one kind of atoms, and these atoms vary from the atoms of another elements. If we take a piece of iron, its atom will vary from the atom of gold. All the atoms of iron will be similar and all the atoms of gold will be similar, but the atoms of both will differ. Every element, it is made up of individual atoms or molecules. All elements are pure and they are homogeneous. All elements have fixed melting and boiling point. Every element will melt or it will boil at a particular temperature, whether if it is pure. Elements cannot be changed into another substances. Elements cannot be broken down into more simpler substances exhibiting its properties. Elements may react with other elements or compounds. For example, here see, hydrogen is an element, chlorine is an element. Both the elements are reacting. But in here, potassium is an element, water is a compound. So, elements may react with other elements or may combine with the compounds. On the basis of these, elements are classified into four types: metals, nonmetals, metalloids, and noble gas. Noble gas is also known as inert gas or rarer gas, RAR, rare gas. Now, metals. In class 6-7, we have studied that metals are hard, compact, they have some luster, they have some many properties like malleability, ductility, sonorosity. These are for the properties. Now, we know the metals are monoatomic, means all the metals, they are monoatomic, means one molecule of metals, they are made up of only one atom, means one atom constitute one molecule of metals. Almost all the metals are solids except mercury, though mercury is a metal but it is found in the liquid state. Then nonmetals are mostly polyatomic. Polyatomic means there one molecule may contains one molecule of nonmetals may contain two or more atoms. For example, this one atom of hydrogen plus one atom of hydrogen combines together to form one molecule of hydrogen. One molecule of hydrogen contains two atoms of hydrogen, so its atomicity is 2. Likewise, one molecule of oxygen contains two atoms of oxygen, atomicity 2. One ozone contains 3 atoms of oxygen, its atomicity is 3. Phosphorus contains 4 atoms, atomicity is 4. Sulfur, atomicity is 8. So, all the nonmetals are polyatomic. Polyatomic means their atomicity is 2 or more. Nonmetals exist in all three states, means solid, liquid and gaseous states. Carbon is a nonmetal, it is found in solid state. Bromine, being a nonmetal, but it is in liquid state. Hydrogen, nitrogen, they all are gases, they are nonmetals. They are 11 in numbers. Metalloids. There are some elements. They are also monoatomic, means their one molecule is made up of only one atoms. So they are neither metals nor nonmetals. They exhibit the dual property, means they show some property of metals and some property of nonmetals. They are called metalloids. They all are hard solids. Here 7 examples are here: boron, arsenic, antimony, germanium, silicon and tellurium. Then inert gases. Earlier I had told you that inert gases is also called as noble gases or rare gases. They are monoatomic, just like metals. All the molecules of inert gases are made up of only one atoms. They do not react with any other elements. They are very rarely found. There are only 6 inert gases: helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon and radon. Here are the comparison of the property of elements. Metals, they have metallic luster. All the metals have some specific shining, but nonmetals, they do not have any luster, they do not have some shining. The metalloids, they have the property of both metals and nonmetals. Noble gases are chemically not shining, they do not have any signs. They are mostly hard except mercury. They can be found in all three states: solid, liquid and gases. Carbon solid, bromine liquid and the other gas, the other are in the gaseous state. Noble gases, they all are found in gaseous state. Malleability. What is malleability? It is a property by which metal can be beaten to form sheets. We know that we call it sheet. In Hindi we call it chadra. Banate hain na darwaja ye sab thok thok ke metals ko. That is called the property of making seed from a metal. It is called malleability. So all the metals are malleable except zinc. We will study it later on. Zinc cannot be beaten into seeds. Zinc is not malleable. Ductility. It is a property by which wires are drawn. So from almost, I am using word almost, from almost all the metals wire can be drawn except zinc, sodium, potassium, these. Here are the properties of compounds. All the compounds, they are made up of at least two or more elements. They are chemically combined in a fixed ratio. The compounds are pure substances. They are always homogeneous, means they have the similar properties, identical physical and chemical properties. All the compounds, they have definite melting and boiling points. The constituent of compound from which it is made up of can be separated only by chemical means. Means we know that sodium chloride, salt is made up of sodium and chlorine. We cannot separate sodium and chlorine from salt physically. They can be separated by chemical process. In future we will study that they can be separated by a process that is called your electrolysis process. Here, during the formation of a compound, heat is either absorbed or liberated. Here if we can see carbon, when burns with in presence of oxygen, it produces carbon dioxide plus a large amount of energy in the form of heat and light is produced. So energy during the formation of compound, heat energy, or simply we can say energy can be absorbed or can be produced. All the compounds are represented by a definite chemical formula. For example, here water is a compound, can be represented by H2O. Now compound. A compound is a pure substance which is made up of two or more elements. Condition is that both two or more elements should be combined chemically in a definite proportion, in a fixed ratio by mass. So compounds is what? It is a pure substance which is made up of two or more substances which are chemically reacted, and the combination is in a fixed ratio. All the compounds are homogeneous, mind it. The properties of compound are entirely different from those of its constituent element. Suppose it is your hydrogen, it is oxygen, forms water. Hydrogen is a gas, oxygen is a gas, but it is a liquid. Here carbon reacts with oxygen, it forms carbon dioxide. It is black in color, it is solid. This one is gas, it is colorless, but after reaction it forms gas and it is colorless. So property of this compound is different from its constituent. Here will be some, here example is given. The properties of sodium chloride are completely different from those of sodium and chlorine. Sodium is soft, highly reactive. Chlorine is poisonous. Its color is greenish yellow with choking smell. If we smell it, we will not be able to breathe freely. But sodium chloride is a white crystal, and which is non-poisonous and useful for our health. All the metals are good conductors of heat and electricity. That means all the metals can pass electric current through it. But non-metals are poor conductors, non-conductor of heat and electricity. But the nonmetals like graphite, it is a very good conductor of heat and electricity. All the metals are sonorous, they can produce sound. Here are some examples. But they are non-sonorous. Here are some exceptional cases. Earlier we have seen that in point number second, metals are solids, but the sodium potassium, they are soft solids. We have studied that ki metals, they do not have luster, but exceptional case is that iodine and graphite, they have luster. We have studied that all the metals are solids, but mercury is a liquid. We have studied that non-metals are ductile, wires cannot be drawn from non-metals, but carbon fiber is ductile. We have studied that they are hard, but zinc is brittle in nature. Graphite, we have studied that they are good conductor of heat and electricity, but tungsten, it is a poor conductor of electricity. We have studied that non-metals are soft solid, but diamond is a non-metal, but it is hardest naturally occurring substances so far. These were the properties, or we can say this is the difference between metals and non-metals. For future, we should know these differences in our concept. Thank you.